dumb.
That's irrelevant. Like, that's not why I called.
Where your husband at?
Babe. Recorder, but don't interact with her.
If you guys have a lease, I'd just like to see the lease.
No, ma'am.
You have no business in personal documents.
At all.
They're like in their 30s.
Yes, yes.
The fuck we got to steal something for?
Babe.
What do we need? Get choked.
Okay. It looks like there's been a misunderstanding. So, apparently, there's been a misunderstanding. When I was driving by, I saw an individual behind the house. And so, I stopped. And
profiling.
And all the windows are closed. And it looks...
It's hot as... The sun is beaming.
And so I'm like shocked and I'm like, okay. And so then I back up and then I see an individual crouched again and I'm like, hi, like, what are you doing at my neighbor's house? And then.
And I greeted you, didn't I?
What's that?
And I greeted you, didn't I?
So that's when I called 911 because I'm like, okay, like, this isn't my neighbor.
I have more video. And the cops did come. Now, I would like to highlight a couple of dynamics here. Number one, she said, if you guys have a lease agreement, I would like to see it. Once again, the equivalent of what? Asking for your freedom papers. In order for you to be in this community, I need paperwork saying that you're supposed to be where you are. I know I have no authority, but I do because I'm white and privileged. And so you must provide me with a copy of your lease agreement. Who in the hell goes around demanding a copy of a lease agreement other than a Karen? Now, she did not realize that day she was actually up against anti-Karens. Here's another dynamic that's really interesting. She said to the 911 operator, there's a misunderstanding. Why are you still on the phone? Why are you still talking about the misunderstanding? You now know for sure there is no criminal activity. And here's another thing. You know how many of these Karens claim they are afraid because all of a sudden there's strange activity around them? Does she look afraid to you? If you were afraid, you would not have been doing all of that in front of the people you are scared of. No, you're not afraid. Not at all. You just wanted to put someone in their place, so to speak. There's more video. Now here comes the cops.
He said that he has a lease and now he's got his phone and he's recording me, so okay. Yeah, cops are here. No. No. And the cops are here.
You did all this for somebody that lives here and pays rent here.
Yeah.
Grown ass man. You driving your car down the street. What's up?
So I guess this woman was harassing my partner.
Oh, please.
No. Literally called the cops on the place where we live because we saw a black man walk in the house.
Come on, bro.
Oh my gosh, this is
happening to me. We can stand right here, bro, to be honest. This is my house.
Okay, I just want to separate from her so we can talk.
He's on our side.
Without her yelling at
us. I do have more. The couple explains the situation to one of the responding officers. I want you to see how this cop responds to them. Here it is.
What's going on? I guess she doesn't believe that we live here. We moved here 3 weeks ago.
About 3 weeks ago.
Annette Williamson, Randy Williamson are the property owners. Okay. We have a lease.
Okay.
It's a really weird issue to have.
I was standing behind my house, right here. She pulls up, she stops.
Okay. What do you mean?
I wave, and she pulled off. I heard her car still humming right here. She got a me and that bitch. I heard her cross the arm and saw way inside, and I came outside.
Okay.
And she asked me what I was doing here. I said, I live here. I walked back outside because I peeped through the window and I seen her right here. So I walked back outside and I asked her, did she need something?
Mm-hmm.
And she said, yes, I do. What are you doing behind my neighbor's house? I said, I live here.
These neighbors?
I don't know. But whoever she's talking about. She said, whoever live here got two kids and they don't. We live here.
Right.
Excuse me.
If you're not listening intently, you may have missed it. But as the black male is explaining why he can exist, while he's explaining, he uses profanity. The cops go, oh, don't no language. Wait a minute. You literally have a citizen who has disrupted your day, Mr. Officer, basically filed a false report through way of a 911 operator. She's the one that has created this ordeal with two innocent individuals. By this time in your investigation, you are aware. And you are telling a grown ass man to stop cursing. Have you heard what your colleagues say, sir? Because I've talked about them on the show, everything from the N-word and beyond. Do you correct your cop colleagues like that when they say racist slurs in front of you? Oh, I doubt it. Now you, once again, another person just wanting to put somebody in their place. I wish a cop would try to tell me what kind of language I can use. All right, Rayyvana, thoughts on this?
Yeah, first I wanna just say directly to my fellow white women, mind your goddamn business. Praise you see a black man existing, that's got nothing to do with you. Mind your business. You think, you know, just standing outside in his yard, nothing to do with you. Keep driving. You don't gotta pull over. Don't gotta ask what he's doing. None of that. You don't have to ask to see the lease, that's for sure. Because who the hell are you? What authority do you have to think that you can demand someone show you their lease because you saw them and they were black and you thought, what right does a black person have to be in my white neighborhood? It's disgusting, it's racist, and they keep telling on themselves.
Yeah, let me do something, all right? Let's go to Rayyvana full mass here. Let's go straight to Rayyvana. All right, just put up on the screen, white women, this is now your new leader. All right,
thank
we got more, absolutely, my pleasure.